February 14, 2019. While the world celebrated the Day of Love, over 40 CRPF jawans were killed in what was one of the bloodiest attacks in Jammu and Kashmir in the last three decades. Jaish-e-Mohammed, a Pakistan-based terrorist group, claimed responsibility for the attack, further straining relationship between the two neighbouring nations. Needless to say, the lives of the jawans and those in JNK were affected. It also had an impact on the field of sports. Firstly, there were calls for India to not play the Cricket World Cup match against Pakistan that is scheduled later in June. A knee-jerk reaction would be to suspend all ties with Pakistan, including not playing or letting them play in any competitions henceforth. But this, being a major decision, can't be taken quickly. Given that the draws for the World Cup have been already made, it wouldn't be possible to restrain Pakistan from featuring in it. And boycotting the game, as has been suggested by many, would be like shooting oneself on the foot. It would mean that Pakistan would be awarded points. Thus, as Sachin Tendulkar and Sunil Gavaskar endorsed, the best thing would be to play them and defeat them thoroughly. The International Olympic Committee has suspended all discussions with the Indian Olympic Association and the government regarding potential applications about hosting future events, cautioning other international federations from awarding them hosting rights. This means that India faces an isolation as far as hosting major tournaments is concerned. Although a decision to this extent is yet to be taken, there are strong indications that the road in this direction isn't smooth. South Africa's sporting isolation during apartheid is well known. For close to 40 years, no team played or included South Africa in the competitions. Isolating Pakistan on somewhat similar terms may be thought about. It is here that we should look at whether it would really help matters. Perhaps isolating them would lead to more retaliation that would then not be limited to just India. Yet, there is one part of me that thinks that just not indulging in sporting activities with Pakistan won't deter the anti-social elements from carrying out their activities. Perhaps it is best for the diplomatic talks to take place and come to a solution to this.